Let's look at what is called universal set and the subset. The universal set, what's that thing all about? Well, whenever you have a problem, any problem, the set, the large set, that big set that contains all other sets, all elements, contains everything, that is called a universal set. Okay, and when it comes to the universal set, the letter that is used to represent that is U. So capital U is reserved for the universal set. Don't call that any other sets U. Use other letters, but so that's reserved for the universal set. Okay, the subset now, so remember U in universal, you call that U. Now as for the subset, if you have any set, other set, but it's totally contained within that universal set, it's called a subset. You can have one or more subset. Okay, so if you have a subset of the universal set, what you can say is that that subset, for example A, that set A is a subset of the universal set U. Okay, now A can also be a subset of another set. Example, if A, all the members of A are also in set B, then A is a subset of B. This symbol looks somewhat like C, but it's a little longer than C. Alright? It's not really C, kind of looks like C. So usually have this thing written from left to right, but it can go the other way as well. Here you can say A is a subset of B, but it's usually the first one on the left and the second one on the right. For example, now suppose you have a bank. Let's call it Workers Bank. Alright? I'm just making that up. There was once a bank in Jamaica known as Workers Bank, but it has been closed, well, not just years, decades ago. I remember that name. So let us say we have Workers Bank. Then you have different departments. Let us say that you have, what are the departments that they have in banks? Let's imagine that there is an accounts department. The account department contains a certain number of employees, but there are also employees of Workers Bank. So the account department is a subset of Workers Bank. You may have the human resource department, HR department. All of those who work in human resources are also in Workers Bank. So in that case, HR is a subset of Workers Bank. HR is a department in itself. It is a set. Workers Bank is a bigger set, and all employees in HR are also employees of Workers Bank. Alright? It could be a case, another example I'm making up. Say there's a high school. I want to make up the name of that high school. Let us call it Howell High School. You say it's Howell High School. Alright? Now, all students who go to Howell High School are in that universal set. Howell High School is the universal set. Now, there is fifth form. Fifth form students are also students of Howell High School. So the fifth form class, that group of students is a set, and fifth form is a subset of Howell High School. Remember, sub means falling under. Alright? If you look up subsonic, then you'll find that subsonic is speed, slower than the speed of sound. Most aircraft, motor vehicles too, are subsonic. Well, virtually all motor vehicles are subsonic. Or in order to travel at the speed of sound, you're looking at traveling 1 kilometer in about 3 seconds. Alright, so sub mean below, under. Of course, the other thing is super, above, like supersonic, faster than the speed of sound. You have certain fighter jets and other aircraft, such as a space shuttle, that travel faster than sound. But the word sub, want to understand, sub fall means falling under. It's smaller than, it's lower than, alright? It's within or below. So, fifth form is a subset of that bigger set, Howell High School. You can also have a subset of fifth form too, you know. For example, those students in fifth form who are members of a certain club. Suppose there is a certain club within the school. Alright? Let's call it Key Club. You have some student. No, not Key Club, because there are other members of Key Clubs in other forms. But suppose fifth form decides that there will be a committee that will organize a trip for the fifth form students. Well, not these students will work along with administrators and teachers to help them organize this trip. Let us call it the trip committee, TC. Only fifth form students are members of this group, because this is a fifth form trip. The fifth form teachers are organizing a trip for fifth form students only. And there are a few students who volunteer to help the teachers in this organization, and they call it the trip committee. or the five trip committee. These students are also members of fifth form group, or the fifth form class, that is 5TC members are also members of fifth form. While fifth form, of course, is a member, this is a set, a subset of Howell High School. So 5TC set is a subset. Those students on the trip committee in fifth form, that set is a subset of fifth form. And fifth form is a subset of Howell High School. You could also have a case where you have 5A, 5B, 5C. In this case, 5C is a subset of fifth form, while fifth form is a subset of Howell High School. Alright? So, that's just looking at sets and subsets for now. In our case, you probably are aware that you could represent this information using a certain diagram, which we'll talk about later, and we'll come back to something like this. Now, let's pause for now and continue with this topic later on.